Hi everyone, I'm Amanda and welcome to my channel. Today we're making this quick and easy crochet cowl. This crochet cowl is great for beginners as it's a simple one row repeat. It also works up really quickly. You can easily make it in a couple of hours. The yarn that I'm using today is Crazy Sexy Wool by Wool and the Gang in the colour Lilac Powder. It's a category 6, super bulky, super chunky yarn. For this pattern, you'll need 2 skeins. I'll also be using a size O, 12mm crochet hook. All the details and links to these materials can be found in the description box below. And I've also got a link to the free pattern on my blog, that's linked below also. To begin your cowl, make a chain of 28. Once you've got your chain of 28, you're going to make a yarn over slip stitch into the back loop only of the second chain from the hook. So the second chain from the hook, 1, 2. So to make the yarn over slip stitch, yarn over hook, insert your hook into the back loop only of the second chain from the hook, pull up a loop, you'll have 3 loops on your hook, pull the first loop through the other 2 loops on your hook to complete the yarn over slip stitch. We'll do it again, yarn over, insert your hook into the back loop only of the next chain, pull up a loop, 3 loops on your hook, pull the first loop through the other 2 loops. And that's the second yarn over slip stitch completed. For the remainder of row 1, you're going to work a yarn over slip stitch into the back loop of each chain until the end of row 1. When you get to the end of row 1, make your final yarn over slip stitch into the back loop only of the last chain. Then chain 1 and turn your work. For row 2, you're going to make yarn over slip stitches into the back loop only of each stitch. So to begin row 2, yarn over, insert your hook into the back loop only of the first stitch. The first stitch is here at the base of the chain 1. Pull up a loop and complete the yarn over slip stitch. And you'll continue doing this until the end of row 2. So making a yarn over slip stitch into the back loop only of each stitch. And I'll meet you at the end of row 2. When you get to the end of row 2, you're going to make a yarn over slip stitch into the back loop only of the last stitch. And take care that you don't miss the final stitch. Sometimes it can be a little bit tight and it can be easy to miss it. So yarn over, insert your hook into the back loop only and complete the yarn over slip stitch. Then chain 1 and turn your work. For the remainder of the pattern, you're simply going to repeat row 2. So working yarn over slip stitches into the back loop only of each stitch. Repeat row 2 until your work measures 23 and a half inches or 60 centimetres. I've now worked my rectangle to the required length. If we have a look, you can see that it measures 23 and a half inches, which is 60 centimetres. We'll now move on and seam our cowl together. So to begin doing this, make sure that your foundation yarn tail is sitting up here in the top left-hand corner, and your working yarn and hook should be positioned down here in the bottom right-hand corner. Fold your rectangle in half so that the two sides meet. And we're now ready to work our seam. And for this, we'll be using the slip stitch seam. To begin the slip stitch seam, come over to this end of your work and insert your hook into the corner stitch and pull a loop through the corner stitch. You'll have two loops on your hook, and to complete the slip stitch, simply pull the first loop through the second loop. And we've now connected both sides together. So to join the next set of stitches, insert your hook into the next stitch. This is the foundation chain row here, so the stitches are, because we worked into the back loops only, you're just left with these loops here. So insert your hook into the next stitch and then come over to the other side and work into the back loop only of this stitch. Yarn over and pull a loop through. You'll have two loops on your hook, and pull the first loop through the second loop to complete the second slip stitch. We'll do it one more time. Insert your hook into the next stitch. Come over to the corresponding stitch on the other side and insert your hook into the back loop only. Pull a loop through both stitches and make a slip stitch. And when you're making the slip stitch seam, make sure that all your stitches are lined up all the way along to the end of the row. And continue making the slip stitch seam, and I'll meet you at the end of the row. When you get to the end of the row, you'll have one stitch remaining on each side. So to work the last stitch, insert your hook, come over to the corresponding stitch on the other side, and instead of going through the back loop, insert your hook under both loops of the last stitch. And this is just to make it a little bit more secure. Pull a loop through both stitches and then make your slip stitch. And that's the slip stitch seam completed. To finish your cowl off, cut your yarn and pull it through. And then weave in your ends. Once you've weaved your ends in, you're going to take your cowl and turn it so that the right side is now facing outwards and the seam is running along inside. And that's you completed your chunky crochet cowl. I really hope that you enjoyed this tutorial. If you liked it, please consider giving it a thumbs up. And remember that the free written pattern is linked below. If you would like to make the beanie to match this cowl, then you can get the pattern for that in the description box below also. Thanks for watching.